Hi everyone, it's Sherry. I hope that you are having a wonderful day. Do you have one of these? If so, stay tuned. Y'all, I get a lot of questions, and unfortunately, I can't answer all of them, but on occasion, I do try to answer the most commonly asked questions. Welcome to my channel. I am so glad that you are here. And welcome to all of my new subscribers and to all of my new friends. Welcome back to my longtime subscribers and longtime friends. Thank you guys so much for the wonderful ways in which you support me and my channel. I really do appreciate everything that you do. And if you're looking for additional ways to support my channel, please check out the links in my description box. Now, if you've made the investment in a finger blade, you know how awesome this little tool is. It's about $6 or $7. I can't remember the exact price, but it is awesome. I've been using the finger blade now for 15, 16, 17 years. I can't even remember how long, but I know I am probably coming up on 20 years of using this little gem right here. And it is so wonderful. It gives me such precision when cutting. And I know that a lot of you do have the finger blade. The question I most commonly get is, how do you change the blade? Well, today I'm going to show you how to change the blade. These are the blades that I use. You get 100 in a pack, and y'all, 100 blades will last you a long time. These I've had now for about a year, and look how many I still have left. And I have four or five finger blades that I use in various locations. So the blades will last you a very long time. When you're buying a blade, you don't have to buy this brand, but just make sure that you're buying a number 11 hobby blade, and it should fit your finger blade. So the way that we change our blade goes against the normal grain of how you twist off and twist on, but this is how you change this blade. You don't change the blade with it facing you. You change the blade with it facing away from you. So to release the blade, we turn this cylinder here to the right. And you can see how it unscrews. Then you simply remove the blade. And when you take out a fresh blade, you're going to notice that you have that little opening right there. And you're going to take the finger blade with the brand name facing up and just stand it up like this and unscrew as far as you can. Then you're going to take the blade, and you can see that we have the crisscross opening there. You're going to take that blade and you're just going to place it down inside of that opening until it goes all the way in. Then all you need to do is screw the cap back on by turning it to the left. And once you have it in, that blade should not move. Y'all, that is how you change the blade in your finger blade. Again, like I said, it goes against the natural way that we are used to unscrewing and screwing something back on. But to take that blade off, you need to make sure that this part is facing you. The blade is sharp. It should not be facing you at all. Turn to the right, loosen it, and then tighten by turning to the left. So that is how you change the blade in your Fiskars finger blade. Then, once you have a nice fresh blade, it makes your cut so much easier. And it all starts with a number 11 hobby blade. I've used various number 11 hobby blades, and I've never had a problem with any one of them fitting my finger blade. So for those of you who've had questions on how you change the blade in the finger blade, there you go. So I hope that this has been helpful. If it has, please hit that like button. If you're not a subscriber to my channel, I'd love to have you hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell so that you will know when I upload a new video or a new fun, helpful tip. As always, please be safe. Be kind. Be the reason someone smiles today. Happy crafting, and we'll chat later. Bye.